welcome back to the Bankers Masterclass series in partnership with Smartstream, looking at the theme of future-proof technology. I'm Kimberley Long, Age Reddit with the Banker, and I'm joined by Haytham Kaddoura, CEO of Smartstream. In this final chapter, we are looking at the next level evolution of banking technology. Thanks for joining us again, Haytham.
Thank you, Kimberley. Always a pleasure.
So what are the main areas of focus now for Smartstream's clients?
So many. I mean, a lot of them has quite a vast agenda. As you know, probably industry research shows that technology spend is up, going to be up by 20 to 25% this year for the institutions. So a lot of people are gearing up. From our clients' perspective, I think some of the priorities are, of course, I mean, being able to keep up to speed with the changes in the market environment, whether new regulations that were delayed and were not implemented because of COVID, and or the regulations coming up to speed now, new. There's a lot, as I said in previous sessions, focus on value-added solutions beyond the automation. How do we build a more efficient and cohesive ecosystem that not only serves our client well, but allows us to operate much more efficiently and address the various aspects of the bank's operations. Some of our clients are talking to us about how do we realign our future technology roadmaps with them, so that we're working in tandem in the next 3 to 4 to 5 years on bringing in new technologies to them. So it's no longer just a short-term agenda component, or we have X as a budget this year, or we're going for an X for a budget next year, but how do we build a more cohesive, longer-term strategy to address some of the challenges institutions are facing today? Definitely, as I said before as well in different sessions, AI and machine learning still remain strong use cases to the institutions. We're working with them on trying to understand where it could be implemented. How do you maximize the value of such technologies in a banking environment? Last but not least, matters like big data, monetization of the data, better forensics, transaction forensics, quicker handling of exceptions. Whether we're looking at areas where we have fees and expense management and help institutions work really closer with their counterparties to identify anomalies in data, enhancing our managed services offering to address greater areas, for example, of financial institutions' need. The list goes really on and on. It's quite vast.
And what do you forecast as being the big trends for the near future?
Honestly, I think the changes driven by the pandemic will continue to evolve over the coming several years, right? Most of us have not been exposed to anything like this on such a global scale. And I believe we've barely touched the surface on some of the technologies that are in the works now. So the value added that AI can bring distributed ledgers to bring, the value of big data, how do you monetize it, better use it, leverage it, how does it help address client churn within institutions, how do you meet the regulatory challenges which are imposing institutions to really to have their data now. It's no longer acceptable for a bank to tell a regulator, I need to run a report overnight and we'll send the data tomorrow. It's relatively instantaneous, right? If you look at the consumer side of the business, of course, with the growth in digital payments, that is bringing and will continue to bring a lot of challenges on cybersecurity, how do you control fraudulent transactions, and at the same time, how do you address them and reduce the cost of institutions addressing those, right? Most of the people I know will no longer be satisfied with, for example, an institution telling them it's going to take 3 weeks to 4 months to resolve a disputed credit card transaction, right? People want answers, they want answers now, and they need a resolution. And all of these are incremental costs on institution. So it's gonna be a fine balance on adapting newer technology, maintaining your customer happy, and at the same time, managing your IRR. Ultimately, a focus on customer, because that's where the pressure is going to be, right? With a lot of the impeding new technologies, impeding coming in players coming into the space, whether pure technology banks, digital banks, and external players like technology vendors, financial institutions are continuing to will have to continue to invest, and to keep their current portfolio and growth rates, right? I'm pretty sure most of the shareholders of financial institutions now are driving that agenda.
That's great. Thank you so much, Haytham.
My pleasure, Kimberley.
And many thanks to you all for joining us for this masterclass series in partnership with Smartstream.